James.
Mick.
This is my daughter Maisie, and this is my grandson, Michael.
Wow, Michael, look at you.
That thing you said to me in the pub, you know, made me think, and here we are. Thanks.
Are we at least on the right street?
Yeah, definitely.
I can't believe I let you sort the viewing.
You think you'll make an offer?
We already have.
Told you we should have used Allsopp and Allsopp.
Oh, it's coming this way. Be very still and it might not see us. Nah, we're done for. It's stopping.
What?
Hey.
Do you have weird dreams?
Sometimes.
Yeah. What about you?
Not at the moment. I don't have any dreams at the moment because I'm not sleeping. But even if I did, I wouldn't tell them to anyone because there is nothing more boring than someone telling you a dream they had.
See what you think of this, then.
She's going to tell us anyway.
I was looking in the mirror, and I looked really weird, and I could pull my hair out.
I know how you feel.
And so I tried my teeth, and my teeth were loose. But then it wasn't me. It was a baby. What the hell does that mean?
Wow. You had that dream with the baby and the teeth and the hair? Mm-hmm. Wow. I don't know if it was Freud or Jung that said, if you have that dream and then tell other people about it, you're really fucking boring.
Rude.
So, you're looking for a job?
Yes, I am.
And do you have any references for that?
They're right next to you.
We have over 100 societies you can join.
Just, I need somewhere to stay tonight, so.
Oh, well, I suppose you could stay with me in Camden.
London. What a shithole. What about you then?
I live in London.
Absolute time wasters.
Ivy's sick.
Julia, why didn't you cancel the party?
Well, why didn't you just not come?
Anyway, it was supposed to be a drop-off, so, you know, quid pro quo.